Today we are going to try to get this image a new look using the free Snapseed app. I had posted the same image on my Insta, though it was edited in Photoshop on desktop. Gonna try to get the same result on mobile today. I'm gonna try my sky replacement technique here. First, turning this image to black and white and choosing the blue color, which gives a good contrast between the foreground and the background. Now, using curves, I'm gonna try making the foreground completely black and the sky white. As you can see, the dark clouds could make it a bit difficult here. So I'm gonna go back to the original state of the image, and in the white balance menu, we'll reduce the temperature to the max to get as much as blue as possible. Now going to the masking screen, tapping on the stacks icon, view edits, white balance stack and the brush icon. Here with the brush value set at 100, just need to brush on the dark clouds to make them blue. No need to get precise here. Roughly brushing on the darker parts of the sky. Now coming back to the black and white effect, you can see those brushed parts have turned completely white, as we had chosen the blue color option initially, which makes them the brightest here. Now using curves, I'm gonna apply a hard high contrast to turn the image literally to black and white. To turn the white spots in the foreground to black, turning the whole image to black by dragging the top right point to the bottom. Now in the masking screen, brushing on those white spots to turn them black. Just need to be a little more precise around these edges. As you can notice, certain black spots like these poles in the upper part are a bit distracting here. So now, turning the image to white using curves by dragging the lower left corner point to the top. With masking, zooming as much as possible and brushing on those to turn them to white. Now we have turned the part of the sky completely white. Now with double exposure, I'm going to add the original image and choose the mode add, which inserts the image only on the black parts, leaving the sky part completely white. Before adding the sky image, I'm gonna get some details back in the darker areas of the foreground by increasing the shadows in Tune Image. Next, I'm gonna add this image using double exposure with the mode darken selected. Just moving it a little to a desired position. As you can see, the dark parts of that image has overlapped on the foreground here. So going to masking screen and brushing out those overlapped parts of the image in the foreground. Now I'm gonna add a couple of selective filters. First one on the greens. Adding some contrast. Also on the train engine. Adding contrast, also add some saturation, which makes it pop. Now we'll add some selective vignette by applying vintage filter with the preset 12. Adding a bit more of the style strength. Then with masking, removing the effect on and around the train, which gives more limelight to the train. Next, to get the fog on the sides of the tracks, using curves, I'm gonna lift the blacks to make the whole image brighter. Also adding greens and the reds to get that orangish tone. In the masking screen, first I'm gonna brush roughly on the right part of the track with 100% opacity. Then decreasing the opacity to 0, brushing out at the bottom to give that soft fog effect. Removing the effect on the train. Also adding the fog effect on the other side of the tracks. Now to add a bright sun on the brighter part of the sky, again using curves to slightly brighten the overall image. With masking, just tapping on the left edge of the sky to make the image more interesting. Now applying some soft contrast selectively on the foreground other than the sky. Next was some dodging on the train engine with the brush tool. Brushing on this big yellow stripe to get it more bright. Also a bit around here. Subtle effect which gives the image more pop. Couple more selective filters to tone down the blues in the sky. also more saturation on the left part of the sky. The final look here. Thanks for watching.